nothing like being at a Republican or a Democratic meeting in an election year. So that's why we're here in New Orleans. They're having the Southern Leadership Conference here. So we've seen what we call the cattle call, which is a lot of people we think are going to run in 2012.
I am strongly considering becoming a candidate for President of the United States in 2012. I would be the first openly gay candidate to seek the nomination of a major political party as its presidential candidate. A new chapter in American history begins here today in New Orleans.
If he's an open gay, then he's a sodomite. And the Bible says that God judged the land of Sodom.
It certainly is a free country.
It's actually refreshing to see somebody who's part of the Republican Party structure, who's openly gay, who stands for what he believes in.
It certainly is a free country.
Fred Carter running for president, I think it's a wonderful idea.
He will be the first openly gay candidate to pursue the office. He's a very exciting guy. I'm happy to see that he's announced.
We need to be open to everyone. The Republican Party needs to embrace everyone that has our same values.
Well, Fred Carter, he has attempted to do everything he can to disrupt the work of the National Organization for Marriage, but really he's had very little effect. He's filed a number of sort of laughable lawsuits, and it doesn't surprise me that he would think he could run for president.
I may not agree or be homosexual, but I mean, it's his right, and our Constitution protects it, and more power to him.
It certainly is a free country.
I'm for man and wife marriage. It would just be someone I would not vote for.
And I'm determined to make history and to make an impact and to go to New Hampshire and spend a lot of time there and stir it up.
So there's no place to be like this conference right now as we head into those November elections.
It certainly is a free country. It certainly is a free country. A free country.